Hi, this is teachertrainingvideos.com. This is Russell Stannard. Today we're going to focus on Camtasia 2019. We're going to look at how you can create quizzes in Camtasia. So for example, you can have some learning content, video, audio, images, etc. And then at a certain point, have a quiz that the users have to do. They can get immediate feedback on that quiz as well. So it's a very popular tool, particularly for anyone interested in building online courses or simply just checking understanding, what we often call formative testing. If you like the video, please like it, please share it, please comment on it, particularly if you've got any questions about Camtasia. Let's get straight into it. Camtasia 2019, how to create quizzes. Okay, so I'm going to show you actually with a real project that I'm doing for a company that are producing learning material for doctors and nurses. So they're producing material for learning English that's based around medicine and hospitals, etc. So what we've got on the screen here is a video of a doctor using a stethoscope followed by two doctors discussing MRI scans. Now what I want to do is I want to add a quiz at the end of the first video. So using these buttons here, I can use these buttons to jump to the end of the first video. So click on that, it will bring me right up to the end of the first video. Then come up to here, modify, and then I'm simply going to put in quizzes and then add quiz, and that brings that onto the table, and you can see it here nice and clearly. What I'm going to do is now just focus in on that a bit tighter. So let me just bring this into the center so that we can see it a little bit more clearly. And you can see here I have got a choice of either multiple choice, fill in the blank, short answer, or true or false. I'll do multiple choice. I write in the default question here. So what we've got is a lady on, or a doctor on the screen using a stethoscope. So I'm going to just ask the question simply, what instrument is the doctor using? So I've written in the question, I'm just going to put in a few answers here. So first of all, I'm going to put an MRI scanner. It's definitely not that. The second one I'm going to put in is stethoscope. And the third one I'm going to put in is otoscope, which is, I do believe, for the ears. The correct answer here being stethoscope. So I click on that. And then I can actually write in the feedback. So if I click here, I can add the feedback. So if you click correct, I'm going to put correct, well done. Okay, comma, correct, well done. And again, I can put in the feedback. If it's not correct, say, I'm going to say correct, incorrect, sorry. And let's put the answer is, and it should be stethoscope. So stethoscope. Right. Spell it correctly. Good. Right. Now, the other good thing about this is that we can decide what happens when they get the question right. Well, in this case, I'm not going to change that. I can actually send them off to another web page or jump to another part of the video. In this case, I'm just going to say continue, but I'm going to add a second question. And I'm just going to ask another question here, very simple question, and I'll keep it on multiple choice. We have got other choices, but I tend to use a multiple choice quite a lot. This second question is going to be how would you describe the doctor's manner? Remember, this is a learning material about kind of language to do with medicine, doctors, etc. So how would you describe the doctor's manner? And we're going to put formal, very serious, which she definitely wasn't very serious, she was quite relaxed, relaxed and friendly, which is the correct answer. And the third one we'll put is worried, very concerned. So the correct answer is that she was relaxed and friendly. Again, I can choose to put the feedback by clicking here and just filling in the feedback. So I've now added my two questions. I've done two multiple choice questions. I've put in the feedback and I've given three possible answers. Remember to choose which one is the correct answer. You need to tell the system what the correct answer is. Now, if we click here, we can actually quickly preview that. And I always do this because I often make typos when I'm rushing to do things. So what instrument is the doctor using? MRI scanner, stethoscope. Okay, so I've made a mistake here straight away. So I need to quickly check that. I'll just come back and do that, and then we'll put in the correct answer, which is a stethoscope, and just see if that worked. And it did, but we know that there's a small mistake. And then how would you describe the doctor's manner? Again, I've made a small mistake there. I'm going to say relaxed and friendly, submit, and again, it's correct. So all I need to come back and edit those few mistakes that I've made. So I put in one answer too many here, so we put, yeah, so I need to delete that. That's good. So that's correct now. And then come to the second one. And if we look carefully at the second one, there's also a mistake, and that's the word manner. Trying to write too fast, basically. So I need to delete that and just write that in correct and put the question. Okay, so we've done the changes. Now we've tested it, we've done the changes, and we can actually now work this through and run it and see how it actually would look. And there's a couple of different ways of doing this. Now, of course, we could add more questions. We could have another quiz. For example, we could move to the end of the video by clicking here and add another quiz at the end of the video. The important thing to understand is that when you create a video that's got quizzes in it, you need to make sure that you hold all the correct answers and the incorrect answers and all the feedback. So you need to have some additional files. It's not going to simply be a simple video file. So you couldn't put this quiz straight onto YouTube and use it, because YouTube would only hold the video file, and in this case you're going to need some additional material. But there are two things we can do. Firstly, and then what I'm going to do is that when you use Camtasia, you get access to what is called screencast.com. So I'm going to go onto screencast.com. I'm just going to load this up and then show you what it looks like. So I'm just coming onto screencast.com. So I'm logged in here to what is called screencast.com, which is basically a place where you can upload your videos, but it allows also for the quizzing to work. So I'm going to call this quiz 2 test. And I'm just going to check on the options and make sure in the options that the quiz is set. That's important. Click on OK. Click on Next. Now, I can actually have it so that when the quiz is done by the students, that a report is sent to me as the tutor. I don't want that, so I'm going to click off that. So I'm not going to plan on having that. I'm going to just rather allow anyone to do the quiz and they get the feedback themselves, but the tutor is not necessarily told of the marks, but we can do that. And then I'm going to click on finish, and now that video is going to be uploaded. And I'll test it in a minute. Got the video. Let's just click and watch the video for a few seconds. The video plays through, and it's going to get to a certain point, and then a quiz will appear on the screen. So let's just give it a few seconds. Once it comes to the end of the video, the quiz comes up. We're going to say take quiz now. And first question is, what instrument is the doctor using? We're going to put here a stethoscope and click on submit answer, and it says correct. Now we click on continue. Second question, how would you describe the doctor's manner? And I'm going to say relaxed and friendly. And I'm going to click on submit answer. Again, we get the feedback. It was correct. Well done. We click on continue. And now the next video will actually play. And if we had a quiz at the end of the second video, then that would also then work, of course. So that's really how the quiz tool works. You've got quite a few options in terms of what types of questions you want to use. It's very useful, particularly for online learning. But it is important to realize that you need to put the videos onto a server that will house the additional information, because you need to hold the correct answers, the incorrect answers, the feedback, etc. And that's why uploading it onto a simple video server won't work. So what's normally going to be is you're going to put it onto your own website. You can put it into something like Moodle, because Moodle is SCORM compliant, or you can do what I've done here, which is upload the video directly into screencast.com. Really hope that video was useful, give you a few ideas of how to do a quiz. Please, if you like the video, like it, please share it, please comment on it. If you've got any questions, please ask me any questions. I'll do my best to answer them. I really hope that video was useful to you. If you come to teachertrainingvideos.com, lots more free videos. There's a special section on Camtasia that includes an introductory video and then a great list. And in fact, I'm just about to add a new playlist of all the new videos for 2019. So we've got both 2018 and 2019. If you want to keep up with my work, then two things you can do. Sign up to my newsletter. That way you get updated on all of the new videos and new material and articles that I've written and have added up online. And secondly, follow me on my YouTube channel that's really kind of growing now. And I think we're up to around about 7,500 followers. If you're looking for training in Camtasia, then please contact me. I do both online courses and face-to-face training. And thank you very much.